Welcome to TLC Rapid Response Team. We're very excited to have you join our team in Vermont, and we're happy to have you here. We wanted to go through some details of the contract that your recruiter has probably already covered with you, but just to make sure you get a final recap before you're deployed out into the field. What is RRT? We deploy staff to facilities throughout Vermont to support their urgent needs. Basically, the way RRT works is when a facility can't staff itself for whatever reason, it might be that they have COVID on site or they're just short-staffed. The facility will reach out to the state of Vermont for assistance. The state will approve that assistance and reach out to TLC. TLC will receive the deployment from the state. Those are the ships that are approved to have our staff report to the facility. As soon as we receive those, we send those to you and have you report to the facility. Unfortunately, a lot of the time, these are very last minute needs. As you can expect, the facility doesn't know that it can't staff itself until something happens. And the state doesn't know that the facility can't staff itself until they're told. And then we don't know that a deployment has been approved until all of these things have happened. So we do our best to let you know about deployments as soon as we receive them, but they are very last minute. That's kind of the nature of this contract. Types of RRT. There are two types of RRT deployments, daily deployments and long-term deployments. Daily deployments might be going to a different facility or location every day or every few days. Long-term deployments are going to be exactly that. You may be at one facility for the duration of your contract or a few weeks. These are when the state has approved a long-term deployment, and instead of sending a different staff member every day, we'll send one staff member to cover the entire deployment. Your deployment coordinator will be Jacqueline. Below is her email address and phone number. She's probably already reached out to you at this point, asking you about your shift preferences. She tries to stay within preferences whenever possible, but as a reminder, you do need to work any shift she deploys you on. Here are the do's of the contract, things that you want to do. One, respond to your deployment within 15 minutes. It's essential that you respond to deployments at all hours. This contract requires you to do that. If that means you need to leave the sound on your phone overnight, make sure to do that. Make sure to always have service available. And if you're in a location that doesn't have great service, log into their Wi-Fi. Report to your shift on time, or a few minutes early is really appreciated by the facilities. It helps you get settled and feel calm and relaxed going into the facility. Bring a great attitude. These facilities are struggling. They need your support. A lot of times their staff, they're not their best selves during these moments because they're stressed out. You're the support that they need. Four, communicate effectively. When you arrive on site, as we mentioned, staff might be stressed. Take a moment to breathe and understand they might not be their best selves. How can you support them? How can you give them the benefit of the doubt? And how can you give the residents the best care? Number five, be prepared to drive. Have gas in your car, a snow brush, hat, mittens, coat, boots, and water. Just in case anything were to happen, you want to make sure you're nice and warm during the winter months. Drive safely. We want you at shift on time, but we always want you to arrive safely as well. Drive the speed limit. We don't want you to speed to shift, go off the road, and potentially hurt yourself. That doesn't help anyone. Number seven, understand that we ask for your shift preferences, as we mentioned before, but we do our best to go by those, but they're preferences. You have to work any assigned shift, day, evening, or overnight. You are the crisis support team. Don't set the contract. Don't decline a shift or not respond to a deployment. Don't complain to a facility staff. They're stressed out already, and you're the support team. So you're there to help and to make their days a little bit easier. Number three, don't arrive late or leave early. We want to make sure you're at these shifts and providing the support that the team needs. Number four, don't expect a full orientation. These facilities are stressed, and they don't have the staff to provide usually one-on-one walkthroughs of the facility or training days. You might be going to a facility for just one shift. They're not going to have an orientation. They're going to expect you to hop right in and start helping. The 40-hour guarantee. This is an important part of your contract, and lots of folks usually have questions about it. You are guaranteed 40 hours for each week that you're here and available to work for a full 7 days. If you're not deployed, you'll still be paid 40 hours. So some of you may not be deployed for a full 40 hours. If that's the case, you will still be paid your 40-hour guarantee unless one of the following exceptions happens. If you decline a shift, call out, arrive late, or leave early. That means that a shift was offered to you and you didn't work it. So there will be no 40-hour guarantee. You'll be paid what you worked that week. If you don't respond to a deployment, same thing, you'll only be paid what you worked that week. If your contract is terminated, you'll be paid what you worked that week. If you have a pre-scheduled time off for that week, which is rare, but if that is included in your contract, you'll be paid what you worked that week. Or if you're not available to work the full 7 days for any reason, if your contract ends midweek, you'll be paid what you worked that week, not a full guarantee. If you have any questions about the guarantee, you can reach out to your recruiter to review this in more detail. It's also listed in your contract. Payroll. We all want to get paid, so here are some tips and tricks. Submit a timesheet for each facility where you work for each week. Separate timesheet for a separate facility. If you work in three different facilities in a week, you're going to submit three different timesheets at the end of the week. Timesheets are due to be keyed in and uploaded into your LEAP account each Sunday. Late timesheets will result in late pay. Get signatures for all of the shifts that you worked. Make sure that it is a charge nurse or someone in charge signing, not another employee. If you're unable to take a lunch break, you must check the box on the timesheet and get a signature from the facility that you skipped a break. If you don't do that, the lunch will be deducted. If you have questions about your pay, please review your pay stub and reach out to your recruiter with the questions and what you think needs to be corrected. The more information the recruiter has up front, the easier and faster they can respond. Our goal is to provide accurate payroll at all times, so if you have any questions, please reach out to your recruiter and they will address this. Who to contact? Your deployment or schedule questions. This would be Jacqueline, and this is her email address. We listed her phone number on an earlier slide as well. She'll often be texting you. Any payroll questions, go to your recruiter. Housing questions, go to your recruiter. Contract questions, go to your recruiter. And any other questions. So your recruiter is your primary point of contact for all things. Jacqueline will cover any deployment or schedule questions. The best way to get in touch with your recruiter is usually through email or text. As you know, they're on the phone a lot during the day doing new interviews. So if you call, they may not be available. But if you email or text them with when you're available, they'll often be able to set up a call with you or respond to any questions more quickly. Thank you again and welcome to TLC.